Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are dealing here Transfer of Property Act 1882. This video is the 7th video of this video series, and if you are not watched our previous video, all the link of previous videos is available in our description box. And those who are want the PDF file of this video series, the PDF file will be available in our Telegram group. The link of Telegram group is available in our description box, so you may join our Telegram group through the link. Now starting here, Transfer of Property Act Part 7. Question number 96. Section 52 of Transfer of Property Act 1882 imposes the provision, this is very important for word for Section 52, provision on transfer or otherwise dealing of any property during the pendency. This is very important. During the pendency of suit, provided the condition laid down in Section are satisfy, the statement is. So before completing this question, first of all we deal here Section 52. So Section 52 here, dealing here transfer of property in pendency of suit. So pending suit relating thereto. So this thing is provided in Section 52. Section 52 dealing here, if the pendency suit in court, one party is transfer his property to another person, such transfer is here pending. So such transfer is prohibiting during the pendency of suit or any other proceeding of the court. This thing is known as the doctrine. This is known as doctrine of lis, doctrine of lis pendency. This is known as doctrine of lis pendency, and it is dependent on a maxim, ut lit pendent nihil innovator. This thing is nothing new, should be institute in pendency of the suit. This thing is provided in doctrine of lis pendency. Now we discuss here what is the basic important points of this section. So the essential points of this doctrine is there must be. So first important point here, there must be. So it is wrong here. Must be pendency. This is very important. There must be pendency of suit. So pendency of suit or proceeding. So suit or proceeding. This is very important. First important point here. There must be pendency of suit or proceeding. Second point here. The suit or proceeding must be pending in competent court. So here pending in competent court, the court should be competent there. So this is second point important here. Now third important point is essential condition of this doctrine is suit or proceeding must not be conclusive. This is very important. So suit oblique proceeding must not be conclusive. So suit or proceeding must not be conclusive. This is third important point. Please note down the point. These are very important. And the next point here, point number 4, a right to immovable property. This is very important. Section 52 deal with immovable property must be directly or specify in question in that suit or proceeding. So third point is there, a right to immovable property must be directly and specifically in question in that सूट, सूट और प्रोसीडिंग, सो दिस इज फोर्थ इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, द राइट टू इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी, दिस इज इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी मस्ट बी इन मस्ट बी डायरेक्टली एंड स्पेसिफिकली इन क्वेश्चन इन दैट सूट और प्रोसीडिंग. नाउ कम टू फिफ्थ इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, द प्रॉपर्टी इन डिस्प्यूट मस्ट बी ट्रांसफर, सो प्रॉपर्टी शुड बी मस्ट बी ट्रांसफर, द प्रॉपर्टी मस्ट बी ट्रांसफर्ड, ट्रांसफर्ड, सो प्रॉपर्टी मस्ट बी ट्रांसफर्ड हियर, विच प्रॉपर्टी ट्रांसफर, डिस्प्यूटेड प्रॉपर्टी मस्ट बी ट्रांसफर्ड. नेक्स्ट लास्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट हियर, द एलिनेशन मस्ट इफेक्टेड द राइट ऑफ द अदर पार्टी, सो द एलिनेशन मस्ट अफेक्टेड अफेक्ट दी राइट ऑफ दी अदर पार्टी, सो विच पार्टी, अदर पार्टी हु इज द डिस्प्यू द पार्टी इन द डिस्प्यूटिंग इन द सूट, सो द एलिनेशन मस्ट बी इफेक्टेड द राइट ऑफ अदर पार्टीज, सो दीज आर द इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट्स आर रिलेटेड टू द डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लेस पेंडेंसी. नाउ कम टू अवर क्वेश्चन हियर, द क्वेश्चन डीलिंग हियर द सेक्शन 52, सो सेक्शन 52 डीलिंग विद देयर डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लेस पेंडेंसी, इट मीन दैट द प्रॉपर्टी इज ट्रांसफर विच इज द डिस्प्यूटेड अंडर द प्रोसीडिंग इन द कोर्ट, सो सेक्शन 52 ऑफ ट्रांसफर प्रॉपर्टी एक्ट 1882 इम्पोजेज द प्रोविजन, सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट इम्पोज द प्रोविजन मीन्स नो कैन बी ट्रांसफर द प्रॉपर्टी विच इज अराइजेज द डिस्प्यूट बिफोर द कोर्ट, सो द प्रोविजन ऑन ट्रांसफर और अदरवाइज डीलिंग ऑफ एनी प्रॉपर्टी ड्यूरिंग द पेंडेंसी ऑफ सूट प्रोवाइडेड द कंडीशन लेट डाउन द सेक्शन आर सेटिस्फाइड द स्टेटमेंट इज, सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज ट्रू, सो अवर आंसर इज हेयर ऑप्शन बी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 97, द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ लिस पेंडेंस, लिस पेंडेंट रिलेटेड टू डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लिस पेंडेंसी, सो इट इज रिलेटेड टू सेक्शन 52 ऑफ टीपीए, सो एम्बॉडीड इन सेक्शन 52 ऑफ ट्रांसफर प्रॉपर्टी एक्ट 1882 पर्टेन टू बोनाफाइड परचेज पब्लिक पॉलिसी, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट हियर. एंड नेक्स्ट ऑप्शन सी हियर, ऑक्शन सेल एंड नन ऑफ दी अबव, सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन आवर आंसर इज हियर पब्लिक पॉलिसी, सो आंसर इज हियर ऑप्शन बी, सो द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ लेस पेंडेंस एम्बॉडीड इन सेक्शन 52 ऑफ ट्रांसफर प्रॉपर्टी एक्ट पर्टेन टू पब्लिक पॉलिसी. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 94, रूल ऑफ लेस पेंडेंस इज एप्लीकेबल टू सूट फॉर स्पेसिफिक परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट टू ट्रांसफर इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी, द स्टेटमेंट इज, सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज ट्रू स्टेटमेंट, द रूल ऑफ लेस पेंडेंस इज एप्लीकेबल टू सूट फॉर स्पेसिफिक परफॉर्मेंस, सो अवर आंसर इज हेयर ऑप्शन ए. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 99, द रूल ऑफ लिस पेंडेंस इज एप्लीकेबल टू सूट फॉर स्पेसिफिक परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट टू ट्रांसफर ऑफ इमूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी, दिस स्टेटमेंट इज, दिस स्टेटमेंट इज ट्रू स्टेटमेंट, सो अवर आंसर इज हेयर बी. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 100, इन केस ऑफ ट्रांसफर हिट बाय द डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लिस पेंडेंस द क्वेश्चन ऑफ गुड फेथ विच इज इसेंशियल टू बी इस्टेब्लिश बिफोर द इक्विटेबल रिलीफ कैन बी ग्रांटेड इन फेवर ऑफ अ सब्सिक्वेंट बैंडी अंडर सेक्शन 41 एंड और 51 ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी एक्ट, सो इन इन दिस क्वेश्चन द केस ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी हिट द डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ लिस पेंडेंस अकॉर्डिंग टू सेक्शन 52, द क्वेश्चन ऑफ गुड फेथ, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इफ हिज दिस ट्रांसफर इज इन गुड फेथ the condition will be not applicable in section 52, but which essential to be established before equitable relief can be granted in favor of subsequent vendee under section 41, so 41 deal with the transfer by unstable owner and section 50 dealing here the improvement made by bona fide holder under defective title, So these sections we were already dealt in previous video. If you are not watched previous video, the link of previous videos are available in our description box. You may watch through their link. So this thing is section 41 and 51 of Transfer of Property Act is. So this thing is there totally irrelevant. There is no value. There is no relation between these things here. So answer is here option C. Next question. Question number 101. The suit for pre-redemption involve the right of specific immovable property and transfer come under. So the suit for pre-redemption involve the right to specific immovable property and transfer come under section 52. So our answer is here option B. Now next question here, question number 102. The Supreme Court held that the act of taking illegal possession of property or the continuance of wrongful possession of property does not amount to otherwise dealing with the property so as attract the section 52 even if the wrongdoer be a party to the suit. This was held in case of Rajendra Singh versus Sama Singh, AIR 1973. So our answer is here option D. Now question number 103. Section 52 of Transfer of Property Act does not affect to. So option A, post transfer right. Yes, it is directly affect the post transfer right. So it is wrong here. Pre-existing right. Yes, section 52 does not affect on pre-existing right. So our answer is here option B. And this thing is provided in case Bishan Singh versus Khajan Singh. Bishan Singh versus Khajan Singh and AIR 1958. In this case, Supreme Court held that the Transfer of Property Act does not affect the pre-existing rights. So, according to our question, answer is here option B. Now, question number 104. Section 52 of Transfer of Property Act does not apply when the defendant become insolvent during the pendency of a suit. The state vested in the official assignee. This statement is, so this statement is true statement. Our answer is here option B. Because here section 52 does not apply when defendant become insolvent during the pendency of suit. And the state vested in the official assignee. So answer is here option B, true. These statements are true. Next question, question number 105. The provision of fraudulent transfer is deal in. So provision of fraudulent transfer is section 53. Section 53 deal with fraudulent transfer. And section 51 dealing here the improvement made by bona fide holder under defective title. And section 50 dealing here the rent bona fide paid to holder under defective title. So it is dealing here with rent and here transfer by the defective title. So it is defective title. So now section 49 dealing here transferees right under policy. So here transferees right under policies in section 49 these things are provided. And fraudulent transfer is directly 53, section 53 after doctrine of lis pendensi, section 52 it comes section 53, the fraudulent transfer. So our answer is here option D. Now question number 106. Every transfer of immovable property made with intent to defeat delay the creditor of transfer shall be voidable. Yes, it is voidable according to section 53 of fraudulent transfer act. The add the option of creditor. So defeated or delayed. Yes, answer is here option E. Every transfer of immovable property made with intent to defeat or delay the creditor of transferor shall be voidable at the option of creditor. So defeated or delayed. So answer is here option A. Question number 107. The marriage settlement made to defeat and defraud creditor is voidable under Section 53 of Transfer Property Act 1882. This was held in case of Alamelu Eki versus Meenakshi AIR 1960. So again I read here Alamelu Eki versus Meenakshi AIR 1960. So our answer is here option C. Now question number 108. Under the provision of Section 53 of Transfer Property Act 1882, the relinquishment by one co-partner in favor of another cannot be said to be a transfer unless it is found to be devised to evade creditor. So our answer is here option A. Now question number 109. Section 53 of Transfer Property Act 1882 does not affect to option A here movable property, option B here immovable property. So Section 53 deal with immovable property and it does not affect on movable property. So our answer is here option A, movable property. Now question number 110, final question of this video 110. The term creditor used in Section 53 of Transfer Property Act 1882 include subsequent creditor only, creditor at the time of assignment only, and option C, both creditor at assignment and subsequent creditor. So our answer is here option C, both the creditor at assignment. This is already included in Section 53, but subsequent creditor and subsequent creditor or subsequent transferee in Section 53, subsection 2 of Section 53 dealing here subsequent transferee. So according to question, the terms creditor used in Section 53 of Transfer Property Act include both creditor at the assignment and subsequent creditor. So our answer is here option C. Now finish this video. If you are still not subscribe our channel, please subscribe our channel and click on bell icon button which provide you a further notification of our video. So thank you for watching Indian Judicial Service.